Alright, what is up? This is another episode of Fixing Stuff with Scotty B.
And Hadley P.
Alright, and today we're going to show you how to clean the big cartridge filters in this in your pool filter. Okay, so you're going to want to do this about once every 6 months or so. If you got a new pool, you can't do it too much. About every 3 months, you're going to keep your filter pumps running nice and smooth. Also, it's a good time to do it if they just did fireworks or something. One of those dates, you're gonna have a lot of crap in your pool. So it's a good time to clean these filters. Keep that running good. I'll show you how to do it. All right, folks, step one. All right, so first of all, you're gonna notice both the pumps are off. So make sure you turn those off. I do it with the app, turn off the pool pump as well as the cleaner. It has its own separate little pump. All right, and then it is gonna be horrible if that guy comes on while you are cleaning it. Pretty sure your pool blows up, whole world comes to an end. So I'm also going to kill the breaker to this to make sure that it can't come back on if my automatic timer or whatever for the cleaner decides to tell it to kick back on. Okay. All right. You only need a few tools to complete this task. Let me show you what you're going to need. First of all, you're going to need a speaker. Keep your mind right. Put some good tunes on. Stay hydrated. Get a good stretch before you do any type of work outside. I like to use the Gator socket wrench. If you do not own one, you need to stop what you're doing and go buy one. It will automatically fit itself to any size nut. That's important. Robo grips, we talked about these before. Like I said, if you don't have them, stop what you're doing, go to Lowe's, go get them. You're going to need a rubber mallet. That's going to get this guy tight whenever you have to put everything back together. Okay, got a pair of gloves as well. My wife likes my hands to stay nice and supple. Okay, so don't let your hands get all busted up. You're gonna have to carry some heavy stuff. I'll show you the next step. All right, so the next step, I'm showing you guys how to take this thing off. A lot of people are intimidated by opening this up and cleaning these guys. It's really not that hard. You can do it. Just make sure you follow the steps. All right, this little guy right here is gonna let air out of this thing. All the way to the right is closed, all the way to the left is open. So keep it closed. You're gonna have to open it up later when you fill this guy back up with water. But basically, you take your robo grips, you tighten it on the nut, okay? Put your socket on the other side. Now this thing should be on there really tight, all right? So, might take a little bit to get it going. Once you get it going, you can just hold the back. Twist this off right here. Put your hardware somewhere safe. If you lose that, I'm pretty sure it would be extremely hard to find. All right, so now you're gonna need your mallet a little bit because this thing is really on there to try to break it loose. That comes right off. We're gonna set that right there on the ground. All right, so now this top should just come right off. You might have to wiggle it a little bit. Got a lot of water in there, so also make sure you don't wear your favorite clothes. All right. Okay. Oh. All right, that looks harder than it is, it really does. All right, so now you got access to your filters. This top piece just comes right off. Set that to the side. So now you got your four cartridge filters. You see how nasty these guys are, so we're going to clean them. I'll show you that step. All right, now I'm going to show you why we clean these guys. If you look at the water, it's nasty. If you look at the filters, they're pretty nasty. Okay, so I've seen them a lot worse than that. I clean them about every 3 months or so, but the more you clean them, the cleaner they are, the better your pumps are going to run. So basically, we're just going to take all four of these guys out, and I like to take them around to the driveway because as you spray them out, they're going to release a bunch of crap dirt on the ground. You want to be able to sweep it up. If you do it on the turf or you're on your grass, you're going to make a big mud hole or a big nasty spot on your turf. So do them on the driveway, concrete or something like that. It's going to take you about 30 minutes. So get your mind right, get in a good mood, get some tunes on, get ready to do that. I'm going to show you that part in time lapse. All right, cool. All right, y'all, we're out front. We're getting ready to clean these bad boys. Now you're going to want to use a spray nozzle on a hose, okay? Not a pressure washer. I like to use the little brass ones. that you get. You can get a really fine spray, get on there. You do not want to use a pressure washer. If you own one, you're gonna have the urge to go Arnold and be like, I'm gonna use the pressure washer, it's gonna be so fast, I'm gonna do it and it's gonna be gone. But you're gonna destroy your filter, so don't do that. So here's how you do it. You take the brass nozzle. Now this is gonna take about 30 minutes, so relax, get some good tunes on. I recommend some Chris Stapleton. And you'll notice, as we go from top to bottom, it turns nice and white. You see all this nastiness coming out, which is why you're doing it in the driveway. All right, check it out. We got the first one done. That's a clean one versus a dirty one. Again, here is why you do not want to do this on your grass or on your turf or in your backyard. You're going to make a mud hole with a bunch of yucky stuff. All right?
I see the sunrise creeping in. Everything changes like a desert wind. Here she comes and then she's gone again. And I'm just a traveler on this earth. Shot my heart behind the pocket of my shirt. I just keep rolling till I'm.
You can see we got four clean, happy filters. We got a nice, clean, happy driveway. We got a kitty. All right, we're ready to put these bad boys back in. A lot of people are gonna pay others to do things like this, but you can do it. It's not hard. Just follow the steps, all right? All right, y'all, so we got everything ready to put back together. Now, this is the scary part, but after you do it a couple times, it'll be easy. Follow this step by step, you'll be fine. So there's a couple things we gotta do before we are able to do that. So grab your handy dandy Robo grips, which I'm pretty sure you can save the planet with. The only tool you'll ever need. There's a drain on the back of this thing. Okay, I'm gonna show you that you're gonna wanna let out so the water gets out. All right, so look, this water's nasty. We're gonna let it out. You got a little drain plug that you're gonna unscrew over there, okay? So we're gonna unscrew that, let that water out, clean it out with the hose, and then we can put everything back together. All right. We've got this cap right here. And you're gonna see all that nasty water is gonna run out. Okay, drain out your drain. So then we're gonna take a hose, we're gonna clean this out a little bit, and we should be able to put everything back. As you can see, you got four filters. You got four little prongs right here, and this little guy has four. It's real easy, it doesn't matter which filter goes where. Just gotta stick them back on there, and I'll show you what to do after that. All right, so you can see there's a bunch of nastiness in there. We're gonna wanna spray that out. I got my brass nozzle. As you can see, I'm a fan of brass nozzles. I try not to use plastic if at all possible. Okay, go old school. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Spray all this stuff out and try to get it to go out the drain. And then we'll put everything back together and go from there. You can see all this nastiness coming out. We don't want that back getting back in the new clean filter. All right, next step, put our plug back in, and then we're going to put the filters back on there. Okay, so just get this tight with your hand. Grab your favorite tool. Righty tighty. Make sure that thing's pretty tight because you do not want water leaking out of this thing constantly. so it's on there pretty good. And we're just gonna grab each of these filters. I'll show you. You just set them down on those little pegs like that. And I'll show you how to put the top on. All right, next step. So we want to fill this back up with water as much as we can. So we got our hose. We're going to turn it on. We're going to fill this all the way up to here before we put that back on. That way it's got less to go whenever you open up the air valve. So you got this guy. You'll notice it looks like this. It's got five. This top piece is going to go over this. Make sure that O-ring is still on there. Okay, anything that's got an O-ring, you need to check. All right, so it's probably even a good idea while I'm here to clean this off. That way you get a good seal, because if you got any dirt or anything inside that O-ring, it's not gonna get a good seal, so make sure they're all clean. All right. And we're gonna take this guy, four holes, four filters, top hole goes on this guy with the O-ring, okay? Now these guys are gonna move around a little bit, so you'll have to just wiggle them until you get all four to go at the same time. All right, it's easier than it looks. Make sure this little plastic guy right here is still intact, because this is what's gonna attach to the air release valve. All right, and that should be right in the middle, so it's gonna fit snug on there when we put the top back on. All right, so we are all full up with water and we're ready to put this guy back on. While you're here, check and make sure that this little valve cap that you put on is not leaking, okay? Another thing you're gonna wanna make sure of, make sure your O-ring is in the right spot, all right? When you put this guy back on, that little thing has gotta fit right in the top, but it should, but also make sure that this is pointed the right direction where you can get access to it, and it sprays a wall and not you when you go to let it out. So you're gonna wanna make sure this thing is on there good. All right, your O-ring is not messed up anywhere. Looks pretty good. All right, so now we're gonna grab the metal ring laying here on the ground. Again, make sure there's no rocks and stuff on the inside of this, anything that's gonna keep it from getting a really good seal. Bolt back in, and we're gonna get ready to tighten this guy back down. The smooth end goes on first. As you can see, I did that wrong. So the trick to this process is not trying to be Superman. Don't go on and twist on it. So you're gonna wanna twist it, get it tight, tap, 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 all around the edge, tighten it up some more, tap, 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 just like you're tightening the nuts on a car tire. All right, so we got it hand tight, ready to go. All right, so here we go. Here we're gonna do the scary part. Switch your socket back to the other direction. All right. This is an instance where you got to use your left hand. Hold this one on the back. Now we're going to give it about 10 or 15 cranks. Okay. And we're just going to go around the edge, tap on this guy. That's going to move it around, get it a nice good seal. You're going to notice it's made this loose again, okay? Gator grip on there. Another 10 to 15 cranks. Again, we're just tapping it, giving it a little love. All the way around until we get it good and tight. So I'm gonna keep doing that a little bit longer. If you don't do this, the one time I tried this and I didn't use the rubber mallet, okay? I didn't get it tight enough. It wasn't sealed right, and it was leaking out of this thing. I had to take it all the way apart and do it again. So don't do that. Use your hammer, 10 to 15 cranks, bang, bang. Keep rotating. All right, so we got this guy tightened up. We're ready to get everything back on. Okay, again, remember, tap it with the hammer or you're not gonna be able to get it tight enough and you're gonna leak around that seal. Another good idea is to take a picture of this and see how close it is before you start. It's gonna wind up being a lot closer than you think. It almost touches, all right? So now it's time to power everything back up. We're gonna start with the breaker. All right, so first things first, turn all your breakers back on, okay? And then you're gonna use your control right here to turn your filter pump back on, all right? And then after that, I'll show you what's next. Oh, there you go, you see it popped on all by itself. That's why you kill the breaker. All right, you'll notice it's filling back up with water here as it turns back on. Everything is low. So you got this guy right here, which you're gonna wanna open up, as well as, remember, we only have half of the water in here, so we're gonna open up the air from here so the air can get out. All right, and this thing will fill back up with water. It's gonna take a little time. You gotta rotate back and forth from this guy to this guy, but you need to make sure it's full all the way to the top and you got only water coming out or it's not gonna act right. All right, so here we go. We're filling back up. The pump's finally started to go. Notice this guy is humming. All right, it's got a long way to go to get that thing filled up. Kind of regulate it, make sure it doesn't go too fast, but you're gonna let this guy out and this guy out, so you got some water coming until it fills that thing all the way up. And then when you're sure that it's full, you're gonna want to check around the edge for leaks, but we're almost done. All right, as you can notice, as you can see, we got a nice good stream coming out of there. That means that guy's full, so we're gonna shut this guy back off. We got this guy right here is nice and full of water. Okay, pump is running smooth. All right, so check out the pool. If you want a nice, clean, happy pool, clean your filters every 4 to 6 months. This has been another episode of Fixing Stuff with Scotty B. Appreciate you watching.